Hey guys, welcome back. So to get started, I am gonna be testing out the e.l.f. primer. So I'm not sure if you saw my video, but about a year or two ago, maybe last year, I did a review on this primer. And to compare it with the Milk Hydro Grip, I did see a difference as far as the residue that this primer did leave behind. So I thought today to just do a review on this primer and see if like what I like about the difference. I know this has gone viral on, let me put this on silent. So I know this has gone viral on TikTok. And the girls are like all, you know, saying this is a staple, this is like really good. So I thought, why not do that? So my face is bare. All I did was lashes. All I did was eyebrows. So I'm gonna start with my skincare routine before I jump into primer. So now I'm gonna use this primer. This primer says, what does it say? It's weird. Oh, okay, let me take it out of the package. So it has way more information than the other one. So just to compare the two, This says this is a power grip primer, and this is a power grip primer with 4% niacinamide. So directions, use fingertips to apply and pat into skin, allow to set for 30 seconds to absorb and activate power grip prior to makeup application. This grips makeup and helps even skin tone with this 4% niacinamide infused clear gel primer. So I am gonna use it. It is a pump. I'm gonna apply this with my fingers, right? It says use your fingertips. Yeah, use fingertips. So let's see. Look at that. Let me see if you guys could see. Ooh. Little ashy. Okay, so I am just gonna apply this before I do my eyes. So I'm just gonna do that. I like the consistency. It feels really good. It feels, not to compare, it does feel like the Milk Hydro Grip Primer. I felt like the blue one didn't as much. It had like a residue, but I like that they rebranded and released this. It feels good on my skin. So I'm gonna set a timer on my phone and I'm gonna set a timer on my phone so I know when the 30 seconds is up, but it feels good. Like it feels really good on the skin. So this, I'm probably gonna have in my rotation. All right, so let me bring you guys closer since I'm gonna be doing my eyes. Bring you up close and personal. So with my eyes, I'm gonna go in if I could find any of my products. That was a quick 30 seconds. So I'm going in with my Kevin Aucoin concealer. I use this to clean up my brows, and I'm just gonna bring some of that concealer to my lid. This is super thick, so a little goes a long way. If you guys only saw how much I grabbed, like I usually just grab from the sides. Okay. So now I'm gonna blend that in with my beauty blender. So I picked up a while ago the Sephora Strawberry and Cream beauty sponge. This does smell like strawberries and cream, but after you damp it, it doesn't, the smell goes away. Like when you first open the package, it's so strong. It smells like a perfume. It smells so good. But when I damped it, I didn't smell it anymore. So I'm just gonna go in with like the corner and just blend this out. And then I'm gonna do the same on this side. I feel like I blended it a little too much, but that's okay. And then I'm gonna use the Laura Mercier setting powder to set that. I'm gonna brush off the excess. And then I'm going to apply the eyeshadow. So I'm gonna go in with this foundation and I am going to apply that here. I'm gonna apply it with a brush and then I'm gonna go in with a beauty blender. I'm gonna apply another pump. So I'm gonna go in with my beauty blender that I used earlier and I'm just gonna blend this out. And this is a medium coverage foundation. I don't like how it looks on the monitor, so I really hope it's the monitor and not the camera. So it looks very red on the monitor, but in person it's not red. This is a neutral foundation. This is not a full coverage, so we're gonna treat this like it's not a full coverage. So next I'm gonna go in with my concealer, bronzer, and set that. So here we're gonna go here. So the concealer I used was Tarte Double Duty Beauty in the shade Tan Deep Sand. And then I'm going in with Fenty, Fenty Matchstick in the shade Expresso. And now I'm gonna blend this out with the other end of my sponge. I'm gonna go back in and I'm gonna use the Kevin Aucoin concealer on my under eye only because I don't like how that Tarte concealer looks. It is darker. And so far, my skin feels amazing with this primer. Now I'm going to set my under eye and the rest of my face. So I'm gonna go in with the Tilbury Beautiful Radiant Concealer. In with my Sephora Micro Smooth Powder, and I'm just gonna use this all over my face just to smooth everything out. And then I'm gonna go in with my Anastasia Beverly Hills Powder Bronzer. Love using this stuff. And then I'm going to use the same bronzer to really like chisel my nose. I'm gonna go in with my Charlotte Tilbury Pillow Talk Push Up Lashes Mascara. I love this mascara. Okay, so this is the final look. Let me just use some setting spray. I'm using the Charlotte Tilbury A-Brush setting spray. Listen, my girl Charlotte Tilbury has some great products. I love using her products, so I'm just gonna